everybody. In today's video, I'm going to tell about the convolution theorem from inverse Laplace transform. So what is this convolution theorem? Generally, convolution is useful for obtaining inverse Laplace transform of product of two transforms. See here, the product of two transforms, and also for solving ordinary differential equations. So this convolution theorem will be very useful in solving ordinary differential equations, that is ODE. Here is the definition. See here, there are two functions, f of t and g of t, with the two functions defined for t positive. We define f of t star g of t as integral 0 to t f of u g of t minus u into du. So if I take u here, I have to take t minus u in the second function. So f of t star g of t can otherwise written as integral 0 to t f of, if I take t minus u in the first function, I have to take u in the second function. Both are same, so depending upon our convenience to solve the problem, we'll choose. And f of t star g of t is called the convolution product. See the product, f of t star g of t is called which product? Convolution product of f of t and g of t. So here is the convolution theorem for you. If Laplace transform of f of t is equal to f of s and Laplace transform of g of t is equal to g of s, then the product Laplace transform of f of t star g of t is nothing but f of s. This product, we have to make this as product f of s into g of s. If I bring this L Laplace transform to other side, it will be L inverse, or else inverse Laplace transform of f of s into g of s is equal to f of t star g of t. So this is the product of two functions, convolution product. What is the formula for this? Integral 0 to t f of u g of t minus u into du. So please make a note of it. This is the definition and this is the convolution product, and I've explained about the convolution theorem. Depending upon this, we have to solve few problems. So using convolution theorem, we have to solve inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s plus a into s plus b and inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s into s square plus 4. And here are few problems which are very easy. See, I am going to solve these problems for you, and let's get started with this. So what is the first problem? Using convolution theorem, we have to solve inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s plus a into s plus b. Here is the product of s plus a into s plus b. How I have to split this? Inverse Laplace transform of s plus a into s plus b, this is of the form, see here, f of s dot g of s. Then what is f of s? So f of s is nothing but 1 by s plus a, and here g of s is nothing but 1 by s plus b. I have to take inverse Laplace transform. Inverse Laplace transform is nothing but, and again here also, inverse Laplace transform of g of s is equal to inverse Laplace transform of s plus b. So what is this value? Inverse Laplace transform of f of s is equal to e power minus e t. So this is inverse Laplace transform of g of s is equal to e power minus bt. After getting inverse Laplace transform, what I have to do? I have to use this convolution theorem. What the convolution theorem statement states? So that is, if you see f of t star g of t into dt, which is equal to integral 0 to t f of u and g of t minus u into du. See here the product, what it states. So which is equal to integral 0 to t f of u. So what is this f of u? See here, in place of t I have to write u, that is au, into g of t I have to take, in place of t I have to take t minus u into du. see how I'll solve this. Integral 0 to t e power au into e power minus bt into e power plus bu into du. I am integrating with respect to u. So this is a constant t. I am sending it out. So it will be integral 0 to t e power b minus a into u into du. So which is equal to e power bt e power b minus a u by, see here again b minus a between the limits 0 to t. So which is equal to e power minus bt. If I substitute the upper limit, it will be e power b minus a into t by b minus a minus e power 0 by b minus a. Then what is the answer here? E power minus bt e power b minus a into t by b minus a minus 1 by b minus a. So the final answer is, see, if I multiply inside, if I go inside, this minus b and plus b will get cancelled. So it will be minus 80. 1 by b minus a if I take out, then if I multiply with the other side, it will be e power minus bt. See, if I multiply with this, plus bt and minus bt will get cancelled and only minus 80 will remain. So this is e power minus 80 minus e power minus bt. So this is how I have solved using the convolution theorem. See here, the question is given as to find the inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s plus a into s plus b using convolution theorem. So I have to write it in the form f of s into f of g of s. So what is f of s here? Clearly f of s is 1 by s plus a and g of s is clearly 1 by s plus b. I have to apply inverse Laplace transform on both sides. After applying, I got f of s, inverse Laplace transform of f of s as e power minus 80 and inverse Laplace transform of g of s as e power minus bt. So in this, if I substitute in this convolution theorem formula, first function, if I take, it is a function in u, so in place of t I have to take u, and g is a function in t minus u. I have to take, wherever I find t, I have to take t minus u, and after multiplying and keeping the integral and substituting the upper limit minus lower limit, I got the final answer as 1 by b minus a is equal to e power minus 80 minus e power minus bt. So hope you all guys understand. And here is another problem. So this is also using convolution theorem. We have to solve inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s into s plus s squared plus 1. Here for my convenience, I am writing 1 by s squared plus 4 as a first function and 1 by s as a second function. See why I am writing like this. So this is of the form inverse Laplace transform of f of s into g of s. So if I take f of s, what is f of s value? So f of s is nothing but 1 by s squared plus 4 and g of s is nothing but 1 by s. See here, if I apply inverse Laplace transform on both sides, inverse Laplace transform of s squared plus 4, that is inverse Laplace transform of f of s is equal to, it can be written as s squared plus 2 square. As you all know from the elementary functions, that is 1 by s squared plus a square is nothing but 1 by a times of sine a t. Here a is equal to 2. This is inverse Laplace transform of f of s. See here, if I apply inverse Laplace transform of g of s on both sides, it will be inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s. So inverse Laplace transform of g of s is equal to 1. I got both the values ready. So I have to apply which theorem? Convolution theorem. What the convolution theorem statement states, inverse Laplace transform of f of s star g of s is equal to integral 0 to t f of u g of t minus u into du. See here, f of u into g of t minus u into du. So this is integral 0 to t, what is f of u? In place of t, I have to write u. It will be half times of sine 2u into, in place of, there is nothing, it is 1 here, into du. So to make my problem easier, I have taken f of s as 1 by s square plus 4 and g of s as 1 by s. So now you got it. So this is half times of sine 2u into du, which is equal to half times of minus cos 2u by 2 between the limits 0 to t. So this is half times of, if I substitute upper limit, it will be cos 2t by 2, minus of minus plus, it will be cos 0 by 2. So which is equal to half times of minus cos 2t by 2 plus half. If I take 2 as LCM, it will be half times of 1 minus cos 2t. So this is how we have to solve using the convolution theorem. See, make a note of it. To find the inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s into s square plus 1, for my convenience, to make my integral easy, I am choosing f of s as 1 by s square plus 4 and g of s as 1 by s. So you note this point, because in that way also we'll get, and it will be complicated. If we take s square as 1 by s square plus 4, then it will be easy. Our problem will be easy. So have taken f of s as 1 by s square plus 4 and g of s as 1 by s, and after implying inverse Laplace transform, I got the first function as half times of sine 2t and g of s as 1. So here is the convolution theorem statement, states inverse Laplace transform of f of s star g of s is equal to integral 0 to t f of u g of t minus u. What is f of t? F of t is nothing but half times of sine 2t. In place of t, I have to write u. So here it is g of t minus u. There is nothing to substitute. I have substituted 1. So half times of integral 0 to t sine 2u into du. For integral sine 2t to u, it is minus cos 2u by 2 between the limits 0 to 2. So after substituting the upper limit minus lower limit, I got the answer as 1 by 4 times of 1 minus cos 2t. So this is how I have solved. Hope you all guys understand, and it will be very easy. In my next video, I'll post how to solve the remaining problems. Until then, keep watching my video, and if you like my video, please subscribe, share it to your friends, and leave a comment below. Thank you so much.